There are two important concepts before you start making your 3D model if you tend to 3D print your model. First is the absolute tolerance, and then the other one is the printing resolution. Hi, I'm PJ Chen, an authorized Rhino trainer. Let's talk about the difference between those two and how important is it for 3D printing. Let's get started. When we open the new Rhino file, you're going to come up this window and give you the template. There are two types of a template in all different dimensions. Let's use millimeter as an example. You have small object millimeter, and you also have large object millimeter. What is the major difference is right here on the right bottom corner, you will see absolute tolerance. And what that means in those two differences is the small object millimeter template has much smaller tolerance. Let's take a look how it's different. I already have this model made, and let's take a look on our absolute tolerance. If you go to Rhino options, and then you can go to unit. Right here you will see absolute tolerance is 0.001 unit. Now, I'm going to open another one as a comparison. This one, I have it pre-opened here. And let's take a look on this one. I'm going to set this one for absolute tolerance is 0.1. So this is 1,000 times different compared to those two files, okay? Let me minimize this window so we can do comparison next to each other. I'm going to copy this model and Control C and Control V to bring this model to the other file, which has a smaller absolute tolerance. If we try to do the model a lot of time, we need to fill the edges. So let's take a look on this one. I'm going to go to the 3D, the solid tool, and we'll go in here for fitted edges. Right here, the radius, I want to set it really small, 0.01. You can just type it 0.01 here. And we're going to pick up this really common mistake happen here is when you get to something really pointed, and then you use too big of a radius and it won't work, so you have to go smaller. So 0.01, if we zoom in, we got a really nice fillet there. Now let's take a look on this one with a larger tolerance, and then we're gonna do exactly the same things. We're gonna go into the solid, and then under the solid tool you have this fillet edges. So we want to pick up this one, and then the radius we want to set it the same, 0.01. Hit enter and pick up the edge. All of a sudden you see the huge chunk of your model is disappear, and both models actually exactly the same. Why the one on the left is working, the one on the right is not working, is based on the absolute tolerance. Because the one on the right absolute tolerance is 0.1, and you want to go smaller than its tolerance to 0.01. That's why it's not working. So let me undo this one, and I want to do any size is bigger than 0.01. So let's do this again. This time I wanted to use the radius is 0.11, which is a little bit bigger than 0.1. And let's take a look. Now it's working. So what I mean is if your model is preset in the tolerance, which is larger, a lot of time when you get into really tiny pointed, and which happened a lot in the jury design, then you will have the problem when you try to fill the edges because the tolerance is too big. You might wonder, PJ, why don't you set it to 0.00001? So that way you can fit it any kind of edges and you have no problem with it. Well, that will increase your file size dramatically. If you have a super strong computer, yes, you might be able to do that, but it's really not necessary. The reason it's not necessary is most of the printer is go to 0.002. So if you do 0.001, it's definitely enough for the resolution on most of the Jewelry 3D printing printer. Let's also take a look on how to prepare the STL file for printing and what kind of a resolution you're looking to it. Let's go ahead and turn them into the STL file by export. And then make sure that you select to STL file, and I'm going to save it three different files for comparison. The first one I'm going to save to 0.001, and here is 0.001. And then you just click OK. And I'm going to save the other two. The other one I want to do 0.002 as my file name, and just for the comparison, it's easy to remember which one is which. And the third one I'm going to do is 0.003 as my file name, and then again 0.003. Okay. Let's take a look on the file size. We just have the 0.001, which is 5,440 KB, and 0.003 is 4,594. It might not appear to be huge different, but if your model is really complicated, it will make a huge difference. So like we say earlier, most of the printer is get into 0.002. So if we're working with our model and set it to 0.001, it's definitely enough. But when you export it, you don't have to do anything smaller than 0.002 because that's what machine can take. Even though you use 0.001 because the printing resolution on the printer is 0.002, then you will still get the resolution for 0.002. All right, so let's take a look on the different adjustment for the 3D printing. A lot of time I will just export select, but if you are really specific in a certain way, you can turn them into the mesh first. The mesh living under the icon over here, or you can go into the drop down menu and then you can find the mesh. So now let's hit on the mesh icon and then we click on our object and then we come in here. Most of the time you will see the simple control, so you can get into the fewer polygon or more polygon, and which I usually will do just more polygon, and then you can kind of preview it. It will kind of mesh them into the little square for you. If you do like it, you can also use the detail control, and in the detail control I won't suggest you to play with have multiple number in multiple areas, but let's get a really quick understanding for what they are. I'm going to turning everything into the zero, and then right here in the density on the first one you have an option between any number below one. So let's try 0.1 and we hit preview. As you can see, the density is a lot looser, and then you can see is you have this point to point become the straight line instead of curve. So the model you're going to print it out, it's going to be really facet. Now if we turn it back to 1 and we hit preview, then you can see it's a lot more denser. Then you say, PJ, can you go up to 10? Let's try it. And then we want to preview, and then you will go back to the number 1. So the density is go from any number from the below 1. The maximum angle is you can create, make sure that each of the angle, it cannot be larger than certain angle. Couple other things you might able to change. For example, you want to change the minimum and maximum edge length. That means in this little square, that is the length you wanted to do for the minimum and maximum. So that's what that means. One of the interesting things is maximum distance edge to surface. What that means is I have a draft here for you. Let's take a look on this draft. Let's say if I'm going to having this circle, and I'm going to turn them into the mesh. All right. Now the red color here is representing the mesh. And then when you have a straight line across point to represent a certain curve, and from that point, the tip of the where the two straight line meet to the surface, original surface, there's a distance there, which is this blue line there, and that is what that mean over there. So that blue line, let's go back to the mesh again, it's represent max distance edge to the surface. So you can adjust that as well. So let's say I'm going to turn everything into the 0, and I'm going to type it 0.1, and let's take a look. So that will be the distance, that tiny little distance from the edge from this point to the tip of the curve. All right, so a lot of time to save my time, I will use the simple control, and then I use more polygon, and then that way I can preview my mesh. Most of the time, what I do on my model is first I check it, there's no naked edges. You go to analyze, then you go to the edge tool. Then you will see show edge. Then you click on the object, you're going to 3D print. And right here on the command bar, you will say it found certain numbers of the edge and there's no naked edges, then you are good to go. So right after that, I will use export. Then I will choose where it's located and giving the file name, let's say PJ. And then when you hit save, it will ask you like what is the maximum distance between the original surface or the solid and the polygon mesh create for this STL file. Right here you need to type it 0.002, and that will be good for the mesh, and then you just click OK, and that will be the STL file you send it for 3D printing. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave the comment. Let me know if you have any questions or any other video you'd like to see. I'll see you next Monday.